What is going on, my beautiful people? In this episode, we are getting my engine ready and prepared to get cleaned up, honed, and tanked. This is super sick. Thank you to Ricardo for letting us into his shop and letting us see what happens behind the scenes.
What?
Makes it quicker, you know? Easier?
Yeah.
But then they hold up.
That's pretty sick.
I use them all the time. That's the parts washer right there.
That is so cool.
Bro, first time I saw this, it tripped me out because I'm so used to just like manhandling everything.
Oh no, for me.
Nah, this is so cool.
This is a lifesaver for me. Yeah.
That's so cool.
No, this thing, yeah, it's been washed. It spins. It's got a bit.
Let's go with you.
It spins in there.
Is there water?
Yeah, once I close it, it'll start shooting the water. It's got jets all around. I push the safety, it's gonna turn on.
Yeah.
But it'll splash all kinds of so back. But it's got the safety.
Yeah, it should be good by now. Because we're gonna throw it in there again a little bit after we do the
pour. Oh, that looks way better.
Oh yeah.
Dude, that
and that's just a little bit, you know? A few minutes.
How long do you usually go in there for?
Depends how dirty they are.
Holy shit.
Yeah, sometimes if they're super dirty, I gotta leave them in there for a couple hours. Did I ever tell you I was at a different spot before I came in here?
How long have you been in this shop?
I moved in here like in 02.
Okay.
Wow.
Damn.
I was used to it, I guess. Right?
This is Ricardo setting up the engine and putting it into the power hone. He bolts it down using the main caps, and he's able to set everything up and get the machine prepared to hone all the cylinders. The setup itself of this process took the longest time. He had to recalibrate the machine completely for my tiny little eensy-weensy cylinders and make sure everything was going to get within spec and in tolerance within each other. He didn't want any cylinders being bigger than the other. Once we actually got into it, the process did not take very long at all.
The setup takes a little longer, but once I have it all set up, it'll be quick, only.
So here he is getting everything ready. He's got his machine all calibrated. The stones are on there, they're set on perfectly, and everything's gonna be within a tolerance of each other. Here we are on the power hone. We counted it up and down, like 6 or 7 strokes, I think it would have ended up being. And it was super quick, like really awesome to see this actually, and I was surprised at how quick it was. Shout out this bird, big shop, open doors, lots of birds coming in. Yeah, so shout out to Ricardo again for letting us through. Shout out Santa Paula Machine and Muffler. Ricardo was awesome. Camera's hot, mic's live. And this thing is, I don't even know if I'm in the shot. We don't really need to get like suited up for this. We could.
Give me some gloves.
Okay. Okay, here's some gloves. All right, so the engine got hot tanked. We got it honed. It's very clean. There's not a lot of dirt on it. We still got a little bit of rubbish here and there, but we're gonna go ahead and tackle that right now. All the loose dirt is gonna come off. We're gonna mask it, we're gonna spray it, and she's gonna look gorgeous. I really can't wait. I'm gonna show you guys some nice tips and some nice tricks to cleaning up this engine. Jack is here to help.
Hello.
Jack's been on the channel before, plenty of times.
Multiple.
And we're gonna go hard. First, we're gonna get all the loose dirt off. I'm gonna try and cover up the cylinders so we don't get anything in there. And we're gonna take any spare gaskets off that have not been taken off yet. Before we start scratching, scuffing, and taking off all this old shitty copper gasket, we're gonna want to take our dowels off so we can have a flat surface to lay down our masking tape. Any set of channel locks, don't put too much pressure on it. They can fold over themselves and just give her a nice little twist and pull it out. You want to save these because these help set your head gasket in place. And if you don't have these, you're going to have a hard time laying it together and you're not going to be too confident in the seal. Usually our blocks have two dowels in them for the head to be set on properly. I only have one, so I'm going to need to source another dowel because they make me comfortable and I like being comfortable. You also have a dowel where your oil filter housing sits, so you're gonna wanna remove this one as well because we are gonna place some masking tape here too.
Cool.
Next, we're gonna shove some towels or paper towels or whatever you got, honestly, into these cylinders. So when we go ahead and scuff up our mating surface, that we don't shove everything into these cylinders. Okay, sweet. So now we got all of our cylinders nice and protected. We're gonna begin by scuffing these up so we can take all of the grime and grease off. For the hard to remove, sticky, stuck pieces, you can use a razor blade and just get nice and under it. You don't wanna hit it too aggressively because then you could scratch this up and obviously that doesn't feel good. So give it a nice shallow angle and try and peel it up. For the rest of this stuff, or how I usually try to clean these is with a Scotch-Brite pad. I just put a little elbow grease in and it shines up pretty quick.
Open them up. This smells like shit.
Now that our block is mostly clean, I think I would have benefited from a deck job, but it's okay. We're gonna move on to taping everything off so we can start prepping for paint.
No, it wasn't. That was a
bit. No. More. Yeah. Overlap it a little.
Fuck. Yeah, baby.
Okay, cool. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit this around the edge, and it's gonna create our outline that we can follow and peel the tape straight back. I might have gotten a little carried away there. But now we can just peel this. Peel this back. Why isn't it working? Peel this back.
Yeah, okay. Glad mine worked.
Okay, life hack myth.
Oh, what?
Now we're gonna do the oil filter housing because that is also bare metal and it is exposed on the side that we were painting. So we can go ahead and set some tape over where the gasket is supposed to be. Yeah. We're gonna go ahead and lightly scuff the engine, get rid of any loose dirt or rust. We're gonna curl up some tape into little balls and stick it into the threaded holes so that when they catch paint, we can just pull the little balls out and our threads will be still clean and nice.
In there.
I don't want anything in there, yeah.
Oh, okay.
I thought balls.
I've never entered this garage.
I think that's just a cover.
Yeah, it is a cover.
Oh, yeah.
Who says that?
Okay, so all of our holes have been covered up. Good to cover your holes. Now we're gonna go ahead and scuff up the engine and then apply some brake grease to our freeze plugs and then we'll be ready to spray it. Isn't that exciting?
Cool.
Let's go ahead and scuff her up. Going in with the Scotch-Brite.
Paint.
Rust. Oh. Really be sure to sand down any flaking rust because if you don't, then your paint's gonna flake off eventually. And you wanna make sure this lasts a long time, especially if you're doing it. Like, if you're in here doing it, just make sure you do it right. Get in the way.
How dirty was this engine?
Pretty dirty, actually. All right, sick. So, the only reason we're using Scotch-Brite pads as well is because, well, I got the engine hot tanked and most of the grease and grime came off, all that 30-year-old nastiness. But if you didn't have the luxury to do that, you could hit this with a wire wheel. You're not gonna hurt anything and you'll do more damage and it'll be fine when you cover it all up with paint. We're gonna put some brake grease on the freeze plugs, and I think she's ready to get sprayed. Oh, and I guess make sure to clean off all that dust that you caused too.
Oh.
Don't want to paint that.
Oh, God.
All right, so now the engine is basically ready. We're gonna go in with some brake grease. The reason we don't use tape on something like a freeze plug is because it's just kind of hard to tape, and you're never gonna get it perfect. Grease is a little easier because you can kind of just put it anywhere and the paint won't stick to it. And when you're done, you can just wipe it off. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply this slowly. What is this?
Grease.
Damn, bruh.
I wish you had brake clean right now.
I thought I spit that out. I was like, did I just
spit? I accidentally got some Sprite on this. That's good. I accidentally got some brake grease on the engine. Paint will not stick there, so I want to be sure to just wipe that off. Okay, back to what I was saying after I was so rudely interrupted by myself. We're just going to apply a nice thin layer. And that's it. Paint won't stick to that. Yeah, there you go, there you go. Get in there.
Up in there.
Get up in there.
Ooh.
Now I'm gonna get a small little piece of cardboard that I can use on the flat edges that I don't want paint to get on. And it's ready for paint. Should be pretty quick, just a nice little scuff and spray. And it'll look like a bajillion times nicer and 30 years newer.
Oh, you saw that finesse.
We're gonna use some. You're not even in the shop. All right. So today we're gonna be using some angel and.
See, that shit is hard.
All right. So today we're using some engine enamel and it's some high temperature paint.
Okay.
So this is a high temperature engine.
Yeah.
It's gonna be banging redline 24/7 and it's gonna get hot.
You know how we do.
So we're gonna need some high temp paint for it.
Awesome.
We got some black paint. Can make it look classy, nice.
Yeah, don't do any other color other than black. I think black just works the best.
All right, let's get to it.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Cool.
It's got a little marble in there. Shake it up.
This is an engine and like not a lot of people are gonna see it, but you still wanna do a good job. It's good to just practice good technique. So we're gonna hit this side with just a quick coverage layer. We're gonna do the same thing the other side. Let them both flash dry a little bit. Then we're gonna go in and try and apply our color. Keep some distance, right? You don't wanna get super close. You don't wanna be super far. 12 inches is good, like a foot away, not too bad. But again, don't be super close, don't be super far. One more shake for good measure. Make sure it's on. All right, sick. Nice, consistent spray. Easy, this is easy stuff. Fine, everything's fine. Covers layer. Dang, that looks pretty good.
Let's flip it around.
Next is the other side. This side's a little more complicated. We do have some cracks and crevices around the oil filter housing area, but don't be afraid. Again, just go light on it. Spray these sections first though, just so you can get some paint on there. And if you do end up going over, it's not gonna run because you're stuck trying to paint more. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Looks good. Spray it upwards. Yeah.
Yeah, I guess there's some.
Ooh. And
doing light coats. Keep it consistent.
Yeah. Keep it also well ventilated.
Yeah, please do this outside.
3-4 coats, not a huge deal.
Get up in there. Hit it from all angles. We'll start plucking out these little these guys.
Oh.
Yeah. God.
And now, honestly, for my favorite part, wiping the grease out of these freeze plugs. Let me just take this out. Right, right? That's pretty good.
Was this a Reebspec certified idea or?
Actually, I learned this in a shop, yeah. I learned this in a shop. Shout out Jerry. Yeah, that looks crazy. It's actually, I prefer doing it when the paint is dry because the paint is dry and yet it sticks together and pulls the grease.
Reinforced cafe vibe.
I think it wouldn't have hurt to put more grease.
No, it wouldn't have hurt to put more grease.
Ooh, that one's nice.
Two of the most satisfying things in this world are picking massive boogers and cleaning grease off of a freshly painted engine.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Is my head in the shot?
Nope.
Well, there we go. We did it. It's nice, clean, looks 30 years newer, and I'm really excited to work on this engine. It's always nice to work on something that's nice and clean and that you're proud of. And I think this looks insane. Like, this actually looks so good. So I hope you guys learned something. I hope you can do it better yourself. Yeah, it's how you clean your engine. I mean, that's how you clean it up. Looks good, right? I think it looks fucking sick. Okay, welcome back. Next in our little iteration of cleaning, we have our piston. This is our piston head, our rod, and we got a wrist pin in here. We're gonna start by taking our rings out from our ring lance and separating everything so that we can put this in a parts washer and clean it all out and clean the gaps between the rings, which are called our ring lance. So, here we have our piston. This is our primary ring, or our compression ring. This ring creates all of our compression. This is our secondary ring, which does secondary things. And these are our oil scrapers. This is a collection of three rings that pull oil down and up on the cylinder walls so we can keep everything nice and cool and flowy and in motion. We're gonna remove these by pulling up on the edge, hooking it over, and twisting. Just like so. We're gonna do this to all of them. There we go. We got six rings on one piston, and now we've revealed our ring lance. In between these little grooves, called our ring lance, is tons of oil and carbon buildup, and we need to clean that out so our new rings can seat evenly and properly. We're also gonna clean all of the oil and grease off of the skirts, these sections here and here. And we're gonna give this thing just a little bath in the parts washer. Should be nice and easy, and it'll come out very fresh and clean. As always, damn, this is all my stuff. As always, we're gonna get suited up. Okay, cool. We got our gloves that are definitely not wet on the inside. I'm gonna ignore that. So, we've had our piston soaking for a little bit in the mystery juice, and I'm just gonna go ahead and start scraping this down with some Scotch-Brite to clean up as much as I can. We got a little light and loose dirt off. I'm gonna go ahead and hit this with a brush to get all of the built, caked on carbon off and try and clean up the rest of the piston.
We got a decently clean piston now. Top of the piston looks good. Carbon's mostly cleaned up, looking nice. The skirts look clean enough for me. Now we have to clean up the ring lance. So on the inside, I like to take our old rings and break them in half, and it fits perfectly. So this will fit great right into our groove, and we can just drag that. We can drag that across our ring lance and clean up all that extra carbon. I'm ready to throw this in along with the other five pistons. And they're gonna go hard. I believe in you.